show.
I'm Andrea in the peach cardigan.
Oh, I'm Allison in the pink cardigan.
And I'm Stacy in the gray cardigan.
Welcome to the happy cardigan hour. Oh, we're glad you're with us today and we're glad to be here.
Yeah.
It's been at least weeks.
Yeah. Days, for sure.
Time has passed.
I know the last two times we set up, we were like, hey, I don't want a podcast. Yeah,
I know.
Because we were gossiping. Big time. We were. So I'll update you on me. Got my yard clean. Had company. Gonna have some more company next week or later this week. It's all good. Now we're up to speed.
Yeah.
Me.
What? Yeah.
4 weeks until graduation.
Nice.
Yeah, it's great, but I also don't... I would rather be asleep for the next 4 weeks. There's a lot going on. But Mom won't let me live at home anymore, so...
Yeah, that's true.
That's fun.
She's my daughter, in case you can't tell. And then let's see, last week we went to Florida.
Yeah, so that's a big deal.
That was part of it. But yeah, I think we worked ourselves up into a frenzy the time before last I was over and decided it wouldn't be a good idea to podcast.
No.
So I had a cold before we left. It got worse, and we got back on Thursday evening. Friday I went to work. Saturday I went to Tulsa with Allison, which is 2 hours.
Oh, yeah, your sticker thing. Yeah. I saw a picture on Facebook about that. That's exciting.
So I'll let her talk about that in a minute. But we went and ate Korean food, and then there was an Asian market there. So I picked up some of those hot noodles for Turner and some different things. Yeah. And I took some 24-hour cold medicine that morning, so I knew I couldn't really have any more of that, even though I was willing to chance it with everything that was going on. But... I saw these, and on a whim, with a line of people in front of me, behind me, in the store full, it just said cold capsules on the end of the box. And I was like, give me some of those Mix-A-Grip cold caplets. And the guy said, have you used those before? And I said, no, as long as they work, it doesn't matter. And he went, And I didn't think
anything
about
it. Was it like the Sri Lankan tea?
Well, I haven't had them yet because Allison suggested that I might not need to take them while I'm driving. I did open one, however, but I got to show you the packaging. I'm going to show them first and then let you see. That's the packaging because it covers, malaise, muscle pain, sneezing. This is muscle pain, in case you're wondering. Sneezing. Catarrh, nasal obstruction. I don't know what some of these words mean. So, fever, chill, dizziness, and headache.
The catarrh, however you say it, that's mucus.
Okay.
And then the malaise is just a general feeling of not feeling good.
Okay. Well, so Allison suggested I not take it. They come in a foil wrapper, individually foil wrapped. It's so up to date.
That's how they legally sell them.
Yeah. But on the back, it specifically says, do not operate, do not drive. Could cause basically
death,
instant sleep. I don't remember how they worded it. So I chose, after I opened it, not to take it because I didn't want to fall asleep.
Be good to look those up, wouldn't it?
Yeah. That's what I thought. It does break down what's in them in the back, but...
Well, I think that paracetamol is like a Tylenol. It's a pain reliever, but...
When
I don't
know
what the other two exactly are. Nothing nasal decongestion, I know, but I don't know what that middle one is.
Coupled with the packaging images and the name, Mix-A-Grip, and
mix
the cashier...
Mix-A-Grip, what is that? Get a grip, Mix-A-Grip?
I don't know, maybe it covers everything. Cashier going, have you had these before? I thought maybe I shouldn't take it. Now I'm going to take one because I'm on the inside of my cold, but
it's either mushrooms or Mix-A-Grip. You choose.
Yeah, it sounds like cement.
Going
right?
On a trip somewhere.
I think I'll take it now.
Will it be a round trip or will it be one?
One-way ticket. We don't know. So tell about your thing Saturday.
There's not really much to tell.
There's a lot to
tell. So I met a small like craft business at another event that I sold art at, and she I guess is starting like a weekly K-pop marketplace at a like a boba tea place. And so I went, and mind you, gas was $40, and that didn't even fill up mom's car, and I was mad. It cost $40. So we went, and I had a lot of new stuff. I had a little paper banner, some confetti that I made. It was exciting. I met a new artist, and I think we had like 6 people come in that actually knew about it.
Yeah.
But I think I made, I don't know, $15, which isn't terrible. But
out of everybody that came in, only one didn't buy.
Something like that.
Yeah.
Yeah. So
she did good. It was the first weekend for them to have it.
Yeah.
It's really, you know, the first one from COVID, too, because they've canceled all the other different things that they've had. So mm-hmm. I felt like they did pretty good.
Yeah, I think so. Mm-hmm. The doors are just now opening back up. So you were there for it. That's exciting.
Plus, it wasn't like a cup sleeve event, which is where you celebrate like one member. Because at that one, I made a lot more, but there were like 50 people coming specifically for that. So,
And this was a K-pop marketplace.
Yeah,
so
they
did
anime.
And it was in Kung Fu tea.
Yes.
Yeah. Salsa.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Their tea was good. I had
it looked cool.
A coffee something another with coffee balls or I don't know.
I can't drink boba. I will choke myself. I will die.
It's weird. Yeah. Mm. I don't like boba myself, but
I like boba.
You do like boba.
I made them drive me 15 minutes extra in Orlando to get me boba after we went to the beach.
I also don't like tapioca pudding.
No.
I've never had
that. And that little thing popping.
My favorite line from the day was, Mom, would you stop greeting everyone because they think you're the artist?
They kept asking her questions.
I'd be like, hi, how are you today?
And I'm like,
and then they'd be like, how much is this one? And I would just look at her and she would just be looking at them or me.
But it was literally written right there.
I mean, they didn't know what that qualified as.
Not my
it was
problem.
A customer question. You
Dang.
Gotta be able to answer that.
Anyway, Mom came up with backstories for all of them and gave them names.
Bored.
It was pretty boring because it got pretty slow.
Did she make them talk to each other, the little sticker people? Did they put on a concert?
She should have done that.
There was that one guy, I saw him come out of there. He had his helmet on and he had a bunch of tattoos.
Tinfoil or
no,
or
a motorcycle okay. helmet. Yeah, thanks, because I would have thought to clarify. I was outside and he came and got on his bike, but he didn't have anything to drink. And then I went inside and was sitting there, and Allison goes, here comes this weird guy.
And his pants were unzipped, and he was a little squirrely. I didn't know what was going on.
He was squirrely, but I think he was just honestly in a hurry all day. Mm-hmm. So he came back, and he said, how much is this one? And I need something that's $4. So he bought a sticker from her and then went to the other one and said, is that J-Hope? And she goes, no, that basically was an entire different band. And he was like, I'll take it. $6, right? So he had a 10. And so I've decided that he was buying for his daughter a girlfriend, probably daughter, the way he looked, and was super excited. But he had to go get cash. Anyway.
He maneuvered himself downtown Tulsa for the first time on his motorcycle.
Probably.
It was nice.
Yeah.
That was his daughter's $10. And he was told.
Yeah. And I thought.
Don't mess it up, Dad.
We all looked at each other when he left. Like, the lady next to me is probably close to my age, the artist. And she was like, I think that he might be buying for his daughter. And we were all thinking, she's going to know that's not J-Hope. They don't all look the same.
Well, I don't think that lady was 45.
She might have been 35 then, because she had wrinkles under her eyes.
Wrinkly?
No, not wrinkly, but I mean, she wasn't as young as she was dressed, I'll put it that way.
Her art looks young. Does that make sense?
Well, I mean, yeah. What's my art look like?
You don't make art.
No, that's true. I'm surprised she didn't just say witchy.
You don't make art, you birth it.
once in a literal blue moon.
It's okay.
When the time is right. Yeah. Not a night before or a summer's eve after.
I'm turning into her, though, because I just made a fake cake out of spackle and styrofoam, and I started making, like, banners and bunting, and that's something Mom did.
She was like, I'm going to make a fake cake, and I was like, out of, like, caulking and stuff, and she's like, yeah. I'm like, oh, yeah, I've done that. She was like, out of this? And I was like, no, mine were cupcakes. I'm sorry. I didn't make
I remember, like, the squishy type ones, and we made like a fake cinnamon roll that we gave to like all the administration at my elementary school.
We did make fake cinnamon rolls.
Yeah,
I've mastered inedible baked goods using everyday kitchen ingredients. Probably just as flammable as
styrofoam talking. Oh goodness.
Oh. Allison is all peach and cream, like mm-hmm. she's not seen the sun in about 6 months. Yeah, you got rosy cheeks and you're sun-kissed, and I still look jaundiced.
I'm sorry.
Because I wore the peach sweater again.
Yeah.
I really have
to stop.
I thought
you said you were going to stop.
It's in the closet. It's only a lightweight one. The other ones are like heavy. I've got to stop. I've got to find a different one.
They have the...
I want a tan one.
Like, oh, that would be good. Like just tan. Yeah. They have the air set at like 72, 75, so I have to wear a sweater all day.
I wear my cardigans and sweaters like more in the summer than I do in the winter.
Is that air conditioning?
Yes. I'll always get under that vent and I'm miserable. I don't like it.
Facts.
I got orthopedic shoes.
Oh, nice.
How do I show them?
There you go.
See that?
They don't
I was informed
like
by
it.
My granddaughter that only really old people and kids get to wear that shiny stuff on their shoes.
Oh, well, she's not wrong.
I think it's reflective as if I were walking.
Yeah, I think it's a safety device.
Uh-huh. It is. Yeah.
Thank you, some of your granny.
But how do you feel in them?
2 inches taller.
Oh, yeah.
And what it does is I have a lift, so it keeps my... it's supposed to help keep, like, my pelvis and my knee and everything in the right position.
Oh, okay.
So, I've had a lot of fatigue, I guess, and a little bit of swelling when I wear them all day. So, I know it's making some type of a postural change.
Yeah.
But, my hip is feeling good. I think it's, hopefully, you know, I'll just wear them as long as I can. I mean, I'll still throw in flip-flops here and there, but... I'm trying to make a conscious effort if I'm going to be up walking more than an hour or two to try to wear them.
I think that's a good idea.
Yeah. And they're made in the USA, so stop that.
In your face.
Yeah. Really. California still has child labor factories, but okay. We want our child slaves to be made in America, too. Anyway. I'm going to show my shoes. These are rainbow Crocs.
I like them.
My grandma said she liked them. And then she called me and said, do you want these Crocs? I said, what Crocs did you buy? They were orthopedic Crocs.
Did you take them?
Yeah. She said she wouldn't wear them. They're kind of weird. They like mold to your foot. Like they're like those ocean. No, they're like the ocean waterproof ones. They're kind of weird.
I just have on black Vans.
She's a skater.
What song did just pop in your head?
He was a skater boy.
Yeah. That's exactly what popped into my head.
Cheers to Avril, right?
Yes. She died in 2003.
Have you seen that conspiracy?
That she was replaced with a drone.
Well, yeah.
It's called aging people and bad cosmetic surgery.
And her handwriting changed. What's that? Memory loss?
I don't know. I can do that from day to day.
I can do that
in the middle of a sentence.
Your handwriting? Oh. I was like, how do you change your handwriting when you're talking?
I don't know if it's her or not. I mean, I don't watch her enough to know, to pick up on, you know, like, they put the pictures side by side, and to me it just looks like before and after cosmetic surgery, but I don't follow her enough to know to catch the voice changes or the...
Yeah.
You know, all that change.
I just like to listen to that kind of stuff.
I would honestly think if we're to the point of drone light changing, you wouldn't know. Like, not drone, I mean like clone. AI. Clone is what I mean. Mm-hmm. But I think it would have been a better replica. So if she is replaced, it's probably a look-alike type scenario. Like the Beatles would have people perform for them different nights and people didn't know. Yeah, because they just needed a break.
Yeah.
So I don't know what the...
That happened with Miley Cyrus. Mm-hmm. And I loved Hannah Montana and I wanted to go. But we didn't have the money to go to a big concert like that. And Mom found that and was like, see, she's not even, I'm not going to pay that much money for her to not even be performing for half the concert. And I was like, Mom, I don't care.
Yeah. So I think Avril's is probably that. Yeah. Like, it's probably like a look-alike thing.
We know that, I'm part of the conspiracy theory, but they say they know they had. Well, I got my Illuminati
card membership in the mail last week.
They know that she had someone who would fill in for her. They're just saying that she's taken over full time now.
That's what I think. Yeah. That's what I think, you know.
Do you fill out the back of a cereal box to get that card?
Yes.
I got to start buying cereal.
Just go to google.china.com.
What cereal? Kashi Go Lean.
Oddly enough, Rice Krispies.
Yeah, just straight up.
Makes sense. Lucky Charms.
Snap, crackle, pop.
Yeah. You have to listen to use your code.
Straight up. I miss those days that you would get excited about toys and cereal or getting to fill the thing out on the back because you found a stamp somewhere and could mail it in.
Or consciously changing your preferred cereal choice just to get the other toy.
Yeah.
And swearing to your mom you do like Sugar Smacks and you will eat them this time.
Yeah. And you don't. You feed them to the birds or the dog until they're gone. And go without breakfast. And hope that she doesn't just go buy them when she goes to the grocery store by herself.
Mm-hmm.
I was always like Cheerios and Grape Nuts. Like, that was my thing. You know, I can't eat Cheerios
anymore.
Honey
Nut Cheerios.
Ooh, yeah.
I like those. I was not really a cereal fan. Because I didn't like milk a lot.
Yeah.
So I don't like that.
I don't know.
I ate Rice Krispies this morning, though. May or may not have put enough sugar in the bowl not to dissolve in the amount of milk I used. And scraped it off the bottom with a spoon. I don't know.
She likes gritty milk. Yeah. That's like my Grape Nuts.
Yeah, with bananas.
Yeah, but I usually eat those for a snack, not a meal.
Me too. I don't like cereal for breakfast.
Do you know what's good with Grape Nuts? Just put it in the microwave for like 10, 15, 30 seconds. Like, it gets the milk at room temperature, and it does that. You know when you let the milk set as you're eating your Grape Nuts, the texture changes?
Yeah.
It automatically makes it that.
Oh.
So you're not like breaking your teeth. Tooth. Okay. I feel like I'm chipping enamel off my teeth when I take those.
You know, I have TMJ. I can't only eat so much Grape Nuts or it makes my jaw want to lock up.
Imagine. It'd be tough.
It's ridiculous.
It is.
Think I could sue him for that?
I would. There's probably a class action lawsuit out there. You just have
TMJ.
Side up.
Suckers.
Oh, goodness.
So, I think I found my neighbor's
Achilles heel.
No. I haven't found that yet. supplier.
Oh.
Only because I pulled up to the house to pick Allison up, and this guy gets out of this little rice burner car. I can't tell you what it is, but it's white, and it has, like, I want to say it's yellow neon. It could actually be a green, I'm not sure, on the fin and on the top of his steering wheel. So he's like, it's nice and very clean. And I see him get out, and I kid you not, his butt was above the roof of that car. This dude is huge, tall, but he has like the skinny legs and the square box body and like a little kid face and haircut. And he goes, and I'm like, hello. So he goes back to the library. So
now we know where to go if you want ecstasy.
Yeah, exactly. He goes to the library. He's definitely the pill guy. Gets a book out, comes back to his car, and is like, I'm like, all right, buddy. I didn't really give him a thumbs up, but
page 17.
Yes, that's what we were saying. I was like, now I got to start watching my library to make sure it's not a pickup drop-off location. Because if that's the case, either we will have no more problem with addicts in my neighborhood.
We can control the drug trafficking of Chickasha. Yeah. That's and be like air traffic control on drugs.
We'll just print off some little teddy bears and happy faces on little sheets off Allison's printer and just cut them in 10 tabs. And mm-hmm. there'll be nothing but ink and paper. Mm-hmm. And then it'll start a war.
No, we can boil down those toothache plants and make ooh, you numb. Ooh,
yeah.
So when they're like, oh, this is intense.
Yeah. And then there'll be a war. Mm-hmm. And I'll just sit on my porch drinking my coffee. Mm-hmm. I mean, if I'm going to have to watch it anyway.
I think he's like the middle guy. Like, there's our neighbor, him, and there's someone above him.
Yeah, because he had,
he wouldn't, if he
I don't want to say any names, but he had the girl that was in my yard with the golf club get out of his car.
Oh, that was her?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So he delivers.
Yeah.
Because if he was the top guy, he wouldn't be seen.
He wouldn't be
there.
Yeah.
He doesn't get the money, he delivers the goods.
Well, he gets some money because his car, and he's got some neon orange nice tennis shoes. I don't know what kind they are, but they are nice.
Well, when we go off air, I'll give you my other information.
Okay.
Shall we arrivederci?
Yeah, let's do that. Bye.